this will be a fun one tonight. These guys are ready to play some football. And both of these teams are just excited about the fact that, okay, here comes the rivalry again. This is what their brothers have been doing for years. And here we go.
This one is it's a pitching wedge that goes out of bounds.
Boy, I wish my pitching wedge would go that far.
Yours and mine both. So it's going to be an instant field position here for the Eastwood Eagles as they will scrimmage from their own 35-yard line. A beautiful night here for football. It's, I would say, almost summer-like.
Oh, it's summer-like, Mick.
Yeah, it's. I mean,
it's summer-like.
Well, for those of us working in production trucks, yeah, it's broiling. But, I mean, outside to the average fan, it's a beautiful night.
Sure.
And that's, well, they're going to kick it again.
Oh,
they're going to say, the official says illegal procedure against Genoa on the kickoff itself, not the fact that it went out of bounds.
Gotcha.
So they move it back 5 yards, and we are going to do this all over again.
Super. Hey, big thanks to Scott Winkowski, attorney at law, helping us out. He'll actually be on our radio show tomorrow over at Heather Downs on 100.7 ESPN, along with Genoa Bank. Of course, the great people over at Danny's in Rossford going to be opening. We'll be talking a little bit about that. Maumee Bay Turf and some of the great people that have been helping us out for years and years. And we'll get to all the great Genoa people after the kick.
And here we go. As the ball is in the air, they're going to go over here to the opposite side. Picked up upfield near the 30, around the 28, and out of bounds goes Mr. Bauer, Jackson Bauer, on the return as he returns it out to the, let's see where they spot the ball. 37-yard line is where they're going to spot it, Mike, and it's going to be even better field position here for the Eagles.
Yeah, that kind of worked out really good for him because We kind of didn't know what was going on there, but now they're going to be able to take advantage of another, 10, 12 yards maybe?
And perhaps. We'll see what happens here. First and 10 for the Eagles. Ball on the left hash at their own 37. Man in motion. Here's the handoff.
Right up the middle, huh?
And that goes to Bryce DeFalco. And DeFalco able to pick up some decent real estate.
Boy, you're going to be seeing that all night tonight too, Mick. It's they just push and push and push and push, and it's just such great, great stuff. Get in the weight room, kids.
Amen. So it's second down and 6 after a 4-yard gain. Ball on the 41. Here's the handoff now. Uh-oh, this time the Genoa defense said no thank you. They said, no way. Isaac Reynolds, the ball carrier, he got shut down by that wall. Well, they're going to say no gain, but that's a generous spot.
Yeah, he just really didn't get to go anywhere, and I think Genoa just kind of knew what was going ahead, the linebackers in the right place at the right time.
So that makes it 3rd down and 6. We're just over a minute into this ball game. And the first big test here for the Eastwood Eagles and also for Genoa. Comments on defense. Can they shut this Eagles attack down? Man in motion, and now here's a handoff. And nope, it's going to be a first down here as DeFalco was able to get it right to about the first down marker and maybe just a smidge more as they'll move the sticks. First and 10 here for Eastwood as they'll spot the ball at the 48-yard line. Nice run there by DeFalco. His front line provided him some space. He was able to dart through there and was able to physically push his way through and move the sticks.
Coming this way.
Hesselbart carries the ball. He's not going to get much, if any. We'll see what they give him. They might give him a yard, and that's about it.
Well, we've seen it. We've seen it at every one of our games here when we get in with Eastwood. Well, both of these teams, it's just being able to just dominate the line like that. That's great.
Just over 2 minutes gone here in this football game. Glad you could join us here on the Toledo Sports Network. Ball again on the left hash. They've kept it pretty simple. Here now is DeFalco. He'll go forward, but this time, and Genoa defense said no thanks as they were very physical. So Bryant in on the stop. He was out there along with Andrew Zapila.
Are we gonna do about this appeal of surveillance thing tonight?
We can do it all day. I'm ready for you, buddy. Anyway, it brings up a third down.
You took your multivitamins before the game again, didn't you, Mick? Folks, you're in for a great game.
Right. Anyhow, remember, this is me. I stumble at English. That's my mother tongue, remember? Okay, third down. Here we go, just over the midfield stripe. Here's the handoff, and this time a good defensive stand as Isaac Reynolds was brought down as he tried to go over right tackle, but he was shut down immediately by Carson Grawman.
Don't think he got there or got anywhere near, so it's fourth.
Yeah, fourth down and five is going to be it, and they will spot the ball at about just outside the 47-yard line of Genoa. So the Eagles will try to pin the Comets in deep. High snap, but the kick is off, and it's a good high kick. Fair catch called for, and it is grabbed at about the 9-yard line as it was grabbed there by Robert Messenger, and that is where Genoa will scrimmage first and 10 with 8:21 to go here in period or quarter number one, and we are still scoreless. So the Comets get ready now to scrimmage first and 10 from their own 9-yard line. Brunkhorst at quarterback. Aaron looks and fires a dart to the left side.
He got it.
Yeah, what a grab there. Nice effort from Austin Teat. Teat has become, very slowly, has become like the go-to guy here in Genoa. You know, I mean, they've got other weapons. You know, you've got Bryant. You've also got guys like... trying to think off the top of my head. You got Tuhalski, you got, oh my goodness. Anyhow, it's second down, but I'll get there. Second and four. Pick up six. So the ball is handed off, and I believe that is Messenger once again.
Maybe got one?
Maybe. It's Antry, I'm sorry. That's, 27. Aiden Antry is the guy that was the ball carrier. And it will be pickup of a yard, so it'll be third and three. Clock continues to run here with 7:21 to go. In the shotgun, empty backfield, trips out to the right. Brunkhorst fires it over to the left side. That pass is complete.
Same pass and play. Exact same one, Mick.
Austin Teat once again.
Watch this.
What a beautiful play. That was a beautiful pass play right there. And like I said before, I mean, they've got other guys out there, you know, Ruiz, they've got, you know, Mason Drummond and stuff. But right now, Austin Teat has become the go-to guy here for Genoa as of recent. Here's the throw out to the right side. That pass is complete.
Woo, boy.
What a grab there as that was snagged by Drummond.
Watch this in slow motion. Hello. Nice job.
What
nice job, kiddo.
Great job by Mason Drummond hauling that one in. They'll move the ball all the way out to the 35-yard line where it'll be first and 10 here for Genoa.
I think, too, with this passing attack that Genoa's been able to do, It's kind of got some people off guard. You know what I mean, Mick?
Yeah, I mean, it is because we'll get into it here after this play. First and 10, full backfield. Here's the handoff. Oh. Cutting through now. Oh, my goodness. A first down pickup here for the Comets. Robert Messenger just slicing and dicing.
Look at this. Beast it.
Nice job by that Genoa D offensive line to give him some room. To run. A nice big pickup there of 13. First and 10 here for the Comets. I was going to say, for so many years, everyone remembers the old days of Comet football. It was always the wing tee.
Sure.
And everyone, you could always count on it. Not anymore. They like to mix it up. Again, another full backfield. Could we see that again? Here's the handoff.
Oh, they got him this time.
This time,
They got him that time. Watch this in a replay, Mick. Everybody collapsed, and there was nothing the offensive line could do right there. Ooh, I hate those kind of plays, you know.
Yep.
Unless you're an Eastwood fan, because that was awesome.
Yes, it was. And you got a Jordan Pickerel was in on the stop there as he dropped Spencer.
They lose one?
Yeah, they lost two. It's second and 12. Here's the snap. Brunkhorst going to air it out. Pulls it down. Flushed out of the pocket. Brunkhorst running the left side. He's going to go out of bounds. A nice pickup as he was able to move, get into Eastwood territory. As they're going to call it a pickup of five, and they're going to spot him at the 49-yard line of Eastwood. Clock continues to or stopped, actually, because he went out of bounds. 5:18 to go here in the opening quarter. Empty backfield once again, trips out to the right. Brunkhorst takes a snap, dropping back, fires it over here on the right side, and that one goes incomplete. Probably the closest person to it actually was Bryce DeFalco, because on defense.
Watch it. Yeah.
Great camera shot there from Rick.
Yeah, that was all Eastwood on that one, because that should have been a pick six. He'd have gotten something really good out of that on a pick.
So the Comets will punt as Brunkhorst. That one didn't get all of that one, but it does take a Genoa bounce, and it will go out of bounds inside the 20. Let's see where they spot it.
Eagle
14-yard line. Wow. Is where they're going to spot it. So,
nice punt.
Yep, so it turned out to be a good punt there from Aiden Brunkhorst, and it'll be first and 10 from the 14 of Eastwood with 5:07 to go here in the opening quarter.
Mick, it's really, really good to have the great people at Genoa Custom Interiors that help us out on these games. Thank you. They're actually going to be putting some new carpeting in my house. And, of course, Frank Homeis, who just had a birthday over at Genoa Jewelers, has just been helping us out for
Happy
years.
Happy birthday, Frank.
Yeah, the old man.
You mean you're getting rid of that Berber? Come on now. Here now, they go up the gut. And that is Bryce DeFalco.
I don't think it's even Berber anymore, my friend.
Well,
steel wool. It's steel wool now. After 30 years, I think it's steel wool.
I was going to say, I went outside and stood on the concrete for a little bit more of a softer fit.
Yeah, it's not good.
Yeah, but still, DeFalco with a pickup of about two. His second down from the Eastwood 16. Clock continuing to run as we approach 4.5 to go here in the opening quarter. As DeFalco once again goes up the gut. Genoa, I think, is they're keying in on him. But the thing about Bryce DeFalco is the guy's just a very physical ball player, and it's hard to slow him down.
Well, and you're entirely right about that, but there has to be a plan, and I'm sure there is a plan, you know, that to stop him so that things can happen, you know, and that's just basically what it comes down to.
Well, it's third down and we'll call it a long four. Ball just touching the 20-yard line.
Oh.
Nice misdirection. Boost, I thought he was going to be gone, but he does get, I believe, just enough to get a first down.
Well, let's watch that one again, because just that blocking that they did, that secondary blocking is what was able to get them that, Mick.
Tell you what, he only had one man to beat there that tackled him. Otherwise, he was gone. Case Boost, man.
We're going to see that tonight from either side. You know what I mean?
Yeah, both quarterbacks like to pull the ball down and run. First and 10 here from the 27-yard line. And here's Isaac going hard. Isaac.
Nice little turn move.
Reynolds, as I was trying to say there. My tongue got locked. But Isaac Reynolds on the carry, another great runner here for Eastwood. Picks up 5 yards.
Hey, big round of applause to the great people over at Taylor Automotive and Tom Cole and Terry Crosby, of course, Steve Taylor, some of our dearest friends, and helping us out with this, and we appreciate it.
Got to tip our cap to them. Love them dearly. Here's Boos going up the gut, able to break free, head down the sidelines. And I tell you what, 68 yards later, it's a touchdown for Eastwood.
Wow. Let's watch that again. I'll tell you what, Mick. He was just able to slowly find, see how he just takes his time, and then he takes off.
Once he bounces outside, there was nobody there. He faked him out, looked like he was going to cut back in, and just blew down the sideline. And a 68-yard touchdown run for the Eastwood quarterback, Case Boos.
Well, that's what you – did we not just talk about this 30 seconds ago?
Yep.
Wow. We must be mind readers or
something.
Or something.
Or something. So Eastwood here getting ready to attempt the extra point, courtesy of Robbie Rothenbuehler. Snap is down, the kick is up, and the kick is good. So with 2:47 to go here in the opening quarter, Eastwood draws first blood as they lead this one by a score of 7-0.
Genoa Bank is celebrating 120 years. Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, President and CEO of Genoa Bank. Since 1902, Genoa Bank has been caring for the financial needs of our neighbors. Our roots remain as we continue to serve our customers, our communities, and our families. Genoa Bank celebrates 120 years by reflecting on our past and, more importantly, focusing on our future. We will continue to make a positive difference in the lives of those who work, bank, and invest at Genoa Bank. Genoa Bank is celebrating 120 years. Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, President and CEO of Genoa Bank. Since 1902, Genoa Bank has been caring for the public.
A 68-yard touchdown run there by quarterback Case Boos of Eastwood, giving the Eagles a 7-0 lead. My goodness.
Well, you're just that's what we're going to see all night. It's blood and guts in the middle, and then all of a sudden it's going to be a breakaway. Now, this is exactly kind of what happened a little more passing last week with Rosford, and Rosford was able to tally up some big points early in the game, and then Genoa was able to fight back.
Well, here's the kickoff from Rothenbuehler as it's going to be grabbed at about the 12. So from the 12-yard line, here comes Messenger up through. Gets a good return as he's out over the 35 to about the 37 or 38. We'll see where they spot it. But still a decent place to start here for Genoa as it looks like they're going to take over from the 37.
Nice job. Nice job. We appreciate Brad Morrison and everybody helping us out, of course, with being one of our main sponsors, helping us get our instant replay all set and working. Thank you, guys. And hey, Danny's, it's going to be open. If you've ever been in Rossford, you got to go to Danny's now. I'm telling you, it's going to be awesome. And I'll be opening up in a week or so.
I have yet. Here's the snap. Runcorse fires a dart out to the left side. That pass is complete. Austin Teat. Able to make some positive yards out of that. It looks like he's going to pick up about three. As he was brought down by Austin Mays. Battle of the Austins there. So it'll be second and seven here for the Comets. And right now, there's no hurry for, if you're a Comet fan, to try and do this all in one play. Here's the snap out of an empty backfield. They fire it over here to the right. The pass is complete to Messenger, and he got hit low, and he's hurting. Hopefully it'll be all right. So clock now starting up again, under 2 minutes to go. First and 10 from the 46 of Eastwood. As Brunkhorst looking downfield, he's got a man, fires.
You get it?
Oh, it was incomplete.
I gotcha.
So that'll stop the clock with a 1:43 to go.
I had a sneaky feeling it would be a quick first quarter.
Well, here we
are. It was going to be like the last couple of them where it's like, whoa.
You thought you were going to have to run like highlights after the game to fill the 2 hours. Second and 10 here. Empty backfield. Another toss again on the right side, but this time it doesn't work. No, it looks like about a yard loss. I was thinking maybe the line of scrimmage, but no. But Antry got drilled about a yard off. So they're going to loss of one. It'll be third and 11.
11. And really? Poor Rick had a battery go bad.
Oops. Empty backfield once again.
Guess what I'm buying this week, Rick?
Brunkhorst. Over here on the right side, it's complete. Now it depends on the spot.
I'll check that one out again. That I don't know. Let's look.
I don't think so.
It's going to be tight. That's going to be a tight one.
I think he's about a yard short. And, yep, you're calling it a yard short. Yeah. Needs to get to the 36, and he's at the 37. So if you're
fourth and one.
Yep. I think they're in the point where they got to go fourth. You're too far out
definitely.
To attempt a field goal.
Yeah, definitely.
Too close for a punt.
This is where you see a lot of the big guy inside.
Here's the handoff and a first down carry.
He definitely got that.
Aiden Antry in on the carry.
Watch this. In, and boom, right there. Nice job.
Picks up a couple.
I always love doing Eastwood Genoa games. How many years have we been doing these now, Mick?
Since
17 years.
Something like that. All I know is back in the early part of the century when we started.
Back in, 1921.
Yeah, we look good for our age. Sure. Here we go, first and 10. Another empty backfield. Brunkhorst looking downfield.
Intercepted!
Oh, my goodness. Picked off and boom. First turnover of the game. It was Bryce DeFalco over there. He almost had one earlier.
Yeah, let's watch it, Mick. See, everything kind of.
He's watching.
He never saw him.
Yep.
Never saw him. Great, great defense. And he just hid behind somebody, and that's what a good linebacker will do.
Yep. So it's first and 10 here for Eastwood from their own 31. 26 seconds to go here in the opening quarter. My goodness. Well, you knew it was going to be something like that. And, well, DeFalco goes up over the left side. Nice carry as he's brought down at about the, it looks like about the 37-yard line. We'll see where they spot it.
And
that should be the final play of the opening quarter.
Pick you up.
So we have got one quarter in the books here at Jerry Rutherford Stadium here on Freedom Field. As well, this battle between Genoa and Eastwood, well, nothing's changed. It's still a battle. But right now it's Eastwood leading the Comets by a score of 7-0.
Big box stores. Choose Gladio.
A hardware store, yet so much more. Your home improvement answer store. A place to design your interior space. A professional and friendly smiling face. Everything you need for your home. And Gladio is locally owned.
Seven nothing Eastwood on top as we get ready to start quarter number two. I am Mick. He is Mike.
Hello.
And, of course, we've got our cameramen extraordinaires today.
Am I the luckiest man on this earth now to have Kurt as a cameraman and a next-door neighbor who takes my garbage out all the time?
It's because you're old. Well, anyway.
I think he does. When his wife, Cha, starts bringing me, like, apple pies and peach pies and things like that, then that's the whole thing.
You'll know you're old, though, if she does that and they're strained.
Hey, I love plums.
Hey, whatever works.
I do. I love plums. They're good for you.
And, of course, we didn't mention the fact that, well, it's third and one.
Yeah.
After that play. That's all right.
We blew it.
But
going to Toledo Sports Network, Cal now.
Never mind.
Okay.
Yard to go here, third down. Ball at the 39 here of Eastwood. The ball going up the gut. And, again,
it's like an F-150 going through mud right there. Nothing's stopping him.
Nope.
Let's see if he got it. Did he get it?
It's just, yeah, oh, yeah.
Oh,
the physicality of it, that's what I'm impressed with.
Oh, yeah.
Is the fact that both these teams up front have got some big boys that can that aren't afraid to hit.
What do you call them?
The Buffet Boys.
There you go.
Well, here we go. First and 10. It'll be Eastwood scrimmaging from their own 42. We have a whistle.
Official's timeout.
An official's timeout. And don't forget, if you want to watch more games like this, if you want to see the library of all the games we've done, even from way back in the day when dinosaurs walked the earth,
sure.
Please go to ToledoSportsNetwork.com. You can find it there. You can find the link over to our YouTube page where we've got just a bazillion games of football, basketball. We've even done everything from volleyball to pro wrestling. Anyway, here's the next play up the gut again.
Wow.
And Kate Boos keeping things interesting, running up the gut there on the right side.
And if you've got that much effort coming out of your quarterback like that, it really makes it tough on the defense, you know, because that one guy you need to cover that certain area, you can't let him, you can't do it, you know.
Well, here we go, second and six from the 46. Here now, Boos again this time around.
Yeah, they got him that time.
Yep, tried to cut, and he was dropped by Tucker Fredrickson.
No gain.
Hey, don't forget, we'll be the sports show that sucks, ESPN 100.7, will be on tomorrow from 8 to 10. We're also on Facebook, so if you're like a Mike Jamison kind of guy or you're part of our ESPN, the sports show that sucks group on Facebook, you can watch us live from there.
From a golf course near you.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go, second or third down and six. Here now is DeFalco driving forward.
It.
Yep, he's going to be brought down about 3 yards short. So, punting situation here for the Eagles.
Maybe.
Yeah, both teams are changing personnel.
Well, you know, we'll talk about this tomorrow on the radio is how much the kicking game has changed, like in the NFL and with college football. Same thing here with high school football. These kickers are incredible. Look at that.
The line drive gets by Messenger. Will he pick it up?
I think he touched
did
it.
The official's not saying it. Now they're saying he didn't. The official says he didn't. So it'll be first and 10 here for Genoa. But a great kick here by Eastwood. So they're going to pin the Comets back deep at their own, looks like 15. Well, correction, 11, I'm sorry. From their own 11-yard line. Got 6:50 or 8:58 to go here in the first half. We'll see now. Brunkhorst. He's going to air it out again.
There he goes again.
He's got a receiver.
And he got it.
Yep, it's complete to Austin Teat.
Wow.
Threw right into double coverage, too. That's the impressive thing.
Watch this. Oh, maybe not. There we go. Oh, it hit the wrong one, buddy.
Yep, that's all right. We'll get to it here in a minute.
Sometimes I screw up.
Hey, you mean you're human? Oh, my gosh.
Oh, yeah.
Little did I know. First and 10 here from the 25. Empty backfield again. Brunkhorst going the other way. Ooh. And it's complete. Good for a first down. Genoa moving the football here as they were deep in their own end.
Oh, we didn't get that one either.
And they're going to spot it at the 40-yard line.
Another first and 10.
Yep. So nice start to the drive here, if you're a Comet fan. So we come up here on 8.5 remaining in the half. Trips out to the left. Bronkhorst going to air it out again.
And, did he?
No.
No. Okay. I got to check that out again. I'm like, okay, let's see that again.
Alex Spencer, the intended target, almost tap, came tap, up with the how do you do catch.
Oh, wow.
So close.
Wow.
But it falls incomplete, so it's 2nd and 10. Tell you what, credit Genoa. They're moving the ball well here.
Yep.
On this drive. 8:26 to go. Here's the snap. Bronkhorst fires it left side. Oh, through the hands of Austin Teat. You do not see that happen very often.
No, he that ball. Oh, should have had that one.
Mm-hmm. So that makes it 3rd and 10 here. They need to get to the midfield stripe. And we'll see if Eastwood, what kind of defensive scheme they dial up, as it looks like they're bringing everybody. It's thrown over on the right side.
Nope.
And again, the Genoa Comet drive stalls as they got to the 40. And four straight passes go incomplete. So a tough break there for the Comets, but so Messenger set to kick here on this fourth down kick. A high snap, but he gets it. Gets away a line drive. It's going to be grabbed. Well, Boos is going to let it go out of bounds.
And bring it out too for him.
Yep. So they will spot the ball. Let's see where they spot the ball at. And it looks like it's at the 28-yard line. So that's where they will scrimmage 1st and 10, Eastwood will, with 8:08 to go here in this first half. And so far, Mike, you know, I mean, it's pretty much, I mean, we talked about it early, about the fact that Genoa was going to open things up a little bit here offensively with the passing game. But otherwise, it's been pretty much typical Genoa Eastwood.
Certainly, and you know both of these teams are so strong up the middle with their running games. It just it opens up those you know sideline passes that well not as much Eastwood's been doing, but what Genoa's been able to do. But yeah, so far awesome game.
Yep. Boos hands the ball off to DeFalco. DeFalco drives forward. He'll let's see pick up maybe 2 yards.
Yeah.
Maybe.
First hit, number 51, Zach
Beerbaum. And yeah, it looks like he got it out to the 30. They're going to spot him at the 31, so it'll be a pickup of 3.
And that clock keeps running.
Yep. Which, for a it's a TV nightmare, but for fans.
No, actually, I'll make it work.
Hey, we can always film the band if we need to. Here now, Boos cuts outside, looking to move inside.
Kid.
What a great, great run there. He had nothing.
Yep.
It looked like he was going to be pinned behind the line of scrimmage, and yet that young man, Case Boos, was able to juke his way all the way to a first down.
Well, we talk about him. I talk about him all the time when basketball's going around, but I'll tell you what, the kid is just an athlete times 10, you know.
Ball at the 38-yard line, 1st and 10 here for Eastwood. Boos, they're looking to air it out. And
wow.
It's a completion for a touchdown. 62 yards. And it's a touchdown for the Eagles.
When something like this happens in an Eastwood game, you just don't think that's going to happen. And once again, they were able to get out, make it look like the run was going to be happening, and Kay Boos just let one go. Nice catch. Look at this. Boom.
Right there on the money. He made that look so easy. A beautiful feed to Bauer. And Jackson Bauer hauling in that loaf of bread, taking it home for 6.
I heard the guys up in the booth screaming he's open.
Yep, even before he threw the ball. And that kick is up, and it is good. So we've got 7 minutes exactly remaining here in the first half. And right now it is all Eastwood as they lead this football game by a score 14-0.
Graymont and Genoa, producers of dochlamide, lime, and hydrate, serving the community for over 90 years. The plant currently has 60 employees. The safety and development of these employees is a focus for your plant. Over 80% of our employees currently live within 11 miles of the plant. Graymont. For more information about this company, you can check us out on the web at www.graymont.com.
So a 62-yard pass play from Boos to Bauer bolsters the Eagles.
And, you know, you start thinking about it here, all of Eastwood's scoring has come off of some pretty really good passing plays.
Yeah, well, except for the 68-yard run, the 62 or 68.
Oh, I thought there was a pass involved in that. I'm sorry, Mick.
Nope, Boos ran it.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm buried in the truck, you know, so I don't get to see anything. You'll have to buy me a Subway sandwich here at halftime.
Okay, that I can do.
I'm sure you could.
I'll airlift it to you. Here's the kickoff.
Drop it like it's hot.
And it's going to be a short kick. Coming back now. Good return. They're still going.
There you go.
Out over the 40-yard line. Messenger is having a good game here on special teams.
Well, you'll see it here, too. It's his ability to go left and right, and he waited until offensive line there was able to get him some holes.
His blockers gave him some room to move. So that means a great field position here for the Comets, and they will scrimmage first and 10 from their own 40-yard line. 6:52 remaining here in quarter number two. You got trips out to the left, an empty backfield. Here's Brunkhorst. He's going to pull it down. He thought he's going to run it. He's going to fall forward for maybe a yard or two. Looks like they're going to give him two. He was brought down by Jaleel Rayford. And if that name sounds familiar, Mike.
Oh, yeah. Know that family.
The Rayford name goes back quite a ways and and means a lot here in to the Eastwood community.
Well, I think what you're going to be seeing here, especially with what Eastwood's able to do on defense, it's going to be the long pass play that's going to help Genoa out.
Well, here we go. Second and 8. And Brunkhorst gets popped.
Oh.
Unfortunately for him.
Brought down by a flock of Eagles leading the pack.
Did you just hear the announcer?
Yeah.
Brought down by a flock of Eagles.
Gotcha.
What's the first thing that went into your and I ran.
Ran so far.
Oh, my goodness.
And that's Eagles, by the way. But, yeah, I get your point.
Yeah, just a flock of.
Flock of seagulls. Flock of Eagles.
Hey.
I was thinking Hotel California, but anyway. Third down and 6 after a 2-yard pickup. Here we go. Brunkhorst. Going to air it out over the middle.
Oh,
complete.
Nice. What are they saying?
Oh, it is complete.
Oh, yeah, it is. Let's see that again.
Inside
here.
The 40 of Eastwood. Fires a dart right
boom.
In there.
Nice job. Nice job. Nice job on camera, too, guys.
Beautiful pass play. So it's first and 10 here for Genoa. They need a score here. 5:20 remaining in the first half. And they've got a goose egg up there that they're looking to crack. Full backfield here for Brunkhorst under center.
24.
Hands the ball off.
Oh.
As Messenger drives over right tackle. Nice pickup.
Got about, 4 out of that?
Genoa Jewelers, 611 Main Street in Genoa, has been serving the area with quality jewelry and gifts for over 19 years. Specializing in gold and silver repairs, Frank Homeis has been a goldsmith for over 30 years. Our selection of Pulsar watches, Precious Moments figurines, Reflections beads, Seraphim classics, and quality Stellar rings, all at a price you can afford. Genoa Jewelers also buys gold and silver and has the perfect gift for that someone special. Stop out today at Genoa Jewelers, 611 Main Street in Genoa.
Oh, fumble.
And 7, and, well, they're able to pick up the ball and run with it.
I don't know if he's going to be enough for the first down, though, Mick. Let's look.
It should be. It looks like it. Wait. They're going to spot it about a yard short.
Boy, that was luck.
Yep, it was.
That ball bounced right into his hand.
So they need about a yard to go, just over.
Second and 2 from the 31.
Third and 2, right?
Yeah, it's third and 2. Here's the handoff to Antry.
I think he got it.
Yep, he got it. He went over the Eastwood 30. He's at the 29, so that'll be enough for a first down. So first and 10 from the 29-yard line. Clock continues to run here as it is now under 4 minutes remaining. If you're a Comets fan, you want to eat up some clock so that you don't give Eastwood too much time to respond.
Yep. Totally agree.
Well, here we go. Under center. Here's the handoff. And Antry takes it for about 8, maybe 9.
Nice job.
Nice run.
Nice. Oh,
that's exactly what Genoa needed right now. Now,
well, it's there, Mick. It's there. But
and also the fact that I think with Eastwood right now, you can see a couple of hands on hips here with a couple of the Hoggies up front. So they need to get a stop here. Man in motion.
Flag. That man in motion was wrong, huh?
Yep. Illegal. Illegal procedure. False start against Genoa. That'll stop the clock with 3:05. And it makes the yards to gain just a little further back. It'll be second down and 8. They'll spot that ball at the Eastwood 27.
Oh, Rick's getting some nice shots. Kurt's doing a good job, too. We're getting some really good footage here tonight.
Very good. Brunkhorst now. The junior quarterback hands the ball off. Here's Messenger. Messenger drives forward for about... we'll look at about 3 yards, maybe. See where they Hesselbart in there on the stop, and that will make it third down. Let's see where they spot. They're going to call it a pickup of 2. So it's 3rd and 6. They need to get to the 19 to move the sticks.
Yeah, we're 2 minutes now, Mick.
Plenty of time.
Sure.
Plenty of time. They just need to get the line to gain. Here's the snap. Brunkhorst fires it over the right side on that beautiful slant that was complete. First down here for the Comets.
Nice job. You'll see it right here, too. Perfect timing. They timed that route so well.
Now, under 2 minutes to go.
He keeps running his hands like that.
That's because he wants to start the clock up, and now they start it up.
I gotcha.
So, let's see what we have here. First and goal from the 9. And now we've got a whistle. All that for that.
Timeout. Eastwood, their first
Eastwood takes their first timeout of the half with a minute 43 to go here in the second quarter.
It's not too early to start thinking about updating your boat or motorcycle with a new sound system. Get custom marine sound system installations for just about anything that floats. And enjoy the open road with motorcycle head unit and sound system upgrades from TAS. Fast, expert installation from the area's leader in connected mobile technology.
TAS Electronics. You know. TAS Electronics. It's hot.
11 o'clock. The boys soccer team will travel. Did you know it tomorrow for a 3 o'clock game? Lady Eagles volleyball team defeated Fostoria last night 3-0, improved to 8-2 on the season. And the JV volleyball team defeated Fostoria 2-0, and are also 8-2 on the year. Both teams will travel to Genoa on Monday.
Gotta tell you, Mick, so far this game, it looked with the score being 14-0, you think, oh, Eastwood's really dominating. But I'll tell you what, this is just a hard-fought game. Three plays have made this a whole different game for both of these teams.
And I don't think at any point, I've never felt Genoa's been out of this at all.
No.
So here we go. First and goal from the 9. Messenger is going to drive forward. He's going to get it to around the 5.
Hard work. Hard work right in there, and you'll see it here on the second on the replay. Pushing with the legs, pushing with the legs, pushing with the legs, and did really a good job with that.
Russell Martin DeFalco in on the stop there as clock continues to run. Second and goal from the 5 here for the Comets. And now, here now is Messenger again. As he falls forward. So we've got a minute to go here in the half. So Badenhop in on the stop and didn't eat at IHOP. So third and goal here from the 3 after the 2-yard pickup.
Mick Seuss.
Ba-dum-bump. Not Masseuse, Mick Seuss. There you go. But here we go. Third and goal from the 3. It's definitely 4-down territory. They go forward with Braden or Brunkenhorst, and he is going to be short.
And now you got to be careful. You only got 20 seconds.
Yep, they got to call timeout here, and they do. So I smell a rollout.
Nope. He dove.
Brunkenhorst driving forward.
Oh, he did?
Touchdown, Genoa. They've got it in there.
So I want to see that again.
Brunkhorst able to drive forward, put it, the ball over the goal line, and get 6 Ooh. Here for the Comets.
Oh, on the second move. On the second move, he got it.
Yep. It wasn't easy, man. That defense from Eastwood, they put up a battle there on that play there. Valiant effort there from the Eagle defense. Here is the point after attempt. And it's blocked.
Mm.
My goodness, when it's not going your way, Agler's point after attempt gets blocked by the Eagles. Amen to that. As the whistle sounds, Agler will kick off. Short kick. It's going to bounce, and it's going to go out of bounds. So it'll be first and 10 here for Eastwood at the 35-yard line.
Once again, big thanks out to Scott Winkowski, who's come on board to help us out. Great friend of both of ours.
Well, yeah, and I saw him the other day. Last week, I saw him at our high school reunion.
Oh, very cool. We had lunch, and he was really excited about that.
Yeah, we talked in about 30 seconds and then didn't talk to each other the rest of the time. Of course,
Catholic, you know, you go, that's
the people that he hung out with and the people I hung out with weren't necessarily all the same people. But I mean, at this point in our lives, everybody gets along with everybody.
Well, exactly. And most of your friends couldn't get the furlough to be there, right? Is that?
I'm not saying anything about that, but
Sorry.
Yeah, that's fine. I understand. Ha ha, I got the joke. Just remember Division 8. Anyway,
all right, here we go.
Ooh, anyhow, no.
Good for you. That was a good one.
Hey, we're fine.
Division 8, but you're right.
First and 10 here. They'll take a knee to end the opening half as Boos. Well, no, they'll hand it off. Well, he'll, he's going to keep it. And, well, he'll be forced out of bounds at his own bench. And that only takes 5 seconds. Also, they got to run another play. It'll be a first down here for Eastwood. Over the 45 to the 46-yard line. So.
Always love coming over here to Eastwood. Of course, basketball is my big thing. But football, we didn't get to last year. And it's really nice to be here.
We didn't get to
here.
Anybody last year.
I know. But I sat on my boat and drank bourbon. You know, that's
whatever it takes.
Exactly.
First and 10 from the Eastwood 46. Should be the last play of the quarter. Boos able to bounce outside. And let's see, does he get out?
Nope.
So that's going to do it for the half. So the clock reaches zero, and we've had an entertaining half of football. Eastwood leading Genoa right now as it's 14-6 here at halftime. Stick around, we'll be back with more right here on the Toledo Sports Network.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Binn, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Binn today.
Blackberry Corner on the corner of 579 and Elliston Road is a proud sponsor of Genoa football and has the best burgers, chicken, and pizza. You know the pizza. Everyone knows the pizza. Blackberry Corner also has charbroiled pork ribs and Jim's famous chicken dinners. Whether it's appetizers, pizza, or a full dinner, the great folks at Blackberry Corner can help fill you up and save you money. Stop out to Blackberry Corners on the corner of State Route 579 and Elliston Road for a meal or just a snack.
So Genoa, who deferred, will receive the second half kickoff here to start quarter number three. Always a fun time here in Eastwood, and, well, today is no exception. We're going to have ourselves a good second half.
I'll tell you what. We said it early in the game, and we knew, Mick, that the things that were going to happen, it was going to be a busted-up-the-gut kind of game. And it has, but we've just seen some great long-distance plays.
And speaking of long distance, that's a doozy of a kick as it goes into the end zone. Robert Messenger just let it go. It's going to be first and 10 here for Genoa on the touchback.
I swear I keep hearing on the internet that they're going to do something now that on a kickoff, in the NFL, if it goes through the uprights, there's going to be, like, they get a point or something. That's going to be a new rule.
They're going to call it a rouge, like they do in Canadian football.
I love it.
It's French. It means red. Rouge? Anyway.
Really?
Yes. You don't know rouge means red?
No, I don't. I don't know my color schemes very well.
In French. Okay, I gotcha. Here we go. Aiden Brunkhorst starting up here for the Genoa Comets. He's going to keep it, but he's not going to get very far. So, the Comets looking to try and get back in. They scored the touchdown, but had their touchdown, the point after, blocked near the end of the second quarter. So, let's see what we do here. Also, by the way, as far as the stats go, I want to make sure we thank the stats people here from Eastwood, Jared McNulty and Olivia Wieschick.
Jared's actually done play-by-play for us for some basketball.
Whoa. And a sack.
Wow.
A big-time sack from Jordan Pickerel.
Watch this.
You look on the replay here.
Just got him.
Just got him by the shoelaces.
Nice job. Nice.
Great job there from Pickerel. That's going to make it third. And, well, let's see. They're going to call it third and 12 from the 18-yard line. Clock continues to run as we're just over a minute in. And they're going to throw it and almost intercepted again.
Wow.
My goodness.
That, my friends, is a dangerous pass.
Badenhop had a really good shot at that one. It was intended for Antry, and it just did not go. So it's a punting situation here after a three and out for the Comets.
Exactly what Eastwood Eagles wanted, and they're going to get incredible field position here and be able to do what they do. They're just going to take time off the clock.
And here's the punt. Line drive. It's going to take an Eastwood bounce.
No, actually, that was a Genoa bounce.
I'm sorry, a Genoa bounce. That's what I meant to say. As it goes out at about the 45-yard line here, and that's where Eastwood will scrimmage first and 10. My goodness. So the opening series for Genoa did not go as hoped for. Eastwood looking to answer after giving up a touchdown near the end of the first half.
I think it's very safe to say here now, Eastwood's going to go into their base, that basic run it up the gut, take some time. And I could be wrong. Cade could just throw another 70-yard bomb here, you know. But you can even tell in the formation.
Well, here we go. As it's going to be Boost taking it around the right side, going upfield,
wow,
driving deep as he was able to get into Genoa territory, and he'll be brought down, but not before picking up a first down, as he will take it for 11 yards. We'll spot it at the Genoa 44-yard line.
Cage just knows where to go, and he follows his blocker so well that he's able to make a really, you know, a 6-7 yard gain into a first down. Great stuff.
Well, here we go. First and 10. Boos hands the ball off. Nice carry there, attempt from Isaac Reynolds. He'll be brought down by Mason Drummond, so it'll be second down, and we'll call it six after a pickup of four. Well, we're 2 minutes into the second half here, and already Eastwood driving.
Hey, Mick, we got to start thinking about that Taylor Automotive.
Unsung hero,
because, you know, Taylor Automotive, of course, is helping us out, but they help the community out so much with all the great things that they do. And I'm telling you, there's going to be a lot to look at tonight.
Here's a beautiful pass over on the left side. Oh, my goodness. Big time pass over there to Bryce DeFalco. And DeFalco, usually you see him with as part of the running game.
Yep.
But he went out after he released, and my goodness, the Genoa defense bought it and rushed after Boos, and Boos, it was an easy toss, easy pitch and catch.
Mick, do me a favor with the transmitter thing that's sitting up there. Turn that over to where Rick's at over there, because it's kind of clogging up.
Yeah, you want me to turn it?
Yeah, just turn it so the antennas are kind of heading toward him.
Good. Hopefully that's better. Is now on the outside. It's a big-time run there of 18 yards. 18 yards here for the Eagles as Boos keeps it, takes it to the house. Touchdown, Eastwood Eagles.
Everybody thought that was going up the gut, Mick. And Cade just got way outside and was just able to take it all the way to the end zone. Nice job.
And they're in the promised land. And Eastwood on their first series of the second half add to their lead. As the point after is getting attempted, the snap is good, the hold is down, and the kick is up and good. So, 8:58 remaining here in quarter number three, and Eastwood right now with the big lead, 21-6.
You've planned and planned. Each moment of your special day just has to be perfect. You don't want to worry about anything. Just know that you've hired professionals to make your wedding day special. Mike Jamison with Creative Video Imagery has produced award-winning weddings for over 15 years. Our company has the equipment and the artistic ability to capture your day on digital DVD, giving you lasting memories of a day you will cherish forever. Call Creative Video Imagery today or visit our website, Creative Video Imagery, making moments into lifetime memories.
So an 18-yard run from Case Boos adds to the Eastwood lead, 21-6.
Boy, did we call that, Mick?
Yeah,
we kind of called that.
Yeah, we did. And now on the Genoa side of the slate, let's see what kind of an answer they have. So that one's going to go and be picked up and brought back.
Oh, look at him go.
One man to beat.
Wow.
Forced out of bounds deep into Eastwood territory is Robert Messenger. A fantastic return. I couldn't see who. I was trying to see who it was that was carrying, but there's a whole group of people there.
24.
But it was Robert Messenger, yep. And big-time return as they will mark the ball at the Eastwood 37-yard line, it looks like.
Nice job.
So now a short field to work with for Genoa.
Here we go, huh?
Yep, see if they can answer. First and 10. Brunkhorst under center. Takes a snap. Hands the ball off. Over on the left side. My goodness. That's a nice physical run.
Mick, have you noticed, though, Genoa in the last two possessions, especially here, it's been more geared toward the run again?
Yeah. Yeah. More, I think it's because of the physicality. You try to tire the other team's line. And, well, if it works, hey, great. More power to you. Second down and 7 after that pickup of 3. The ball at the Eastwood 34-yard line. In the shotgun is Aiden Brunkhorst. Empty backfield with trips to the left. He'll take the snap. Fire a dart to the left side. Austin Teat, the reception, dives forward. So he'll still be well short of the first down.
That's going to make a tough third down.
Yep. Looks like about 3rd and maybe 5.
Might want to turn that thing back the other way now. It's got to be kind of pointed at him.
So here we go, 3rd and 5. Brunkhorst fires it on the left side to Teat, and it is complete for first down.
Nice. Boy, he drilled that too.
So it's a first down here for the Comets. As they are driving just outside the red zone. Trips out to the right this time for Brunkhorst. In the gun in the backfield alone. Here's the snap. Brunkhorst fires it over the middle. It's a flag flies. And this one may be an interference call.
Let's look at this.
Let's see what we got on the replay.
Huh. Hey, must have. There must be interference because that's where that flag threw.
Yep. So, the penalty, well, they're still discussing it. Right there around the 12-yard line. So, 7:07 remaining while they discuss this.
It's a good thing for me, Mick. I like it.
Well, let's see. They're going to pick the flag up and call an inadvertent whistle. Or wait a minute. Let's see what we got. Pass interference. Now they decide.
Wow.
Pass interference on the Eastwood defense. And they're going to move the ball into the red zone. And let's see where they stop it. 12-yard line is where they're going to spot it. So it'll be a fresh set of downs here for the Comets. Once again, heavy on the right side. They got 4 over there. Here's the pass. Pass is complete for a short pickup. So they'll give it about maybe 2 yards. So it'll be 2nd and 8. Mason Drummond on the reception there.
A gain of 2. Bring up 2nd and 8 from inside the 10.
So if you're Genoa, you have to be methodical about this.
Andrew Hall and a green Mercury, please move your vehicle. You are
now
blocking someone in. Again, Andrew Hall, green Mercury.
Again, empty backfield here for Brunkhorst. He'll take the snap, or he'll keep it. He's going to run it himself. He's going to be close, but he's going to be about a yard short of the line to gain.
Well, he got there. He got close.
Well, let's see where they spot him. They spot him at about the, yeah, it looks like they're going to spot him at about the 4, so it's going to be 3rd and 2.
Gain of 6. Bring up 3rd and 2 from the 4.
Well, here we go. 3rd and 2 from the 4. Clock continues to run. 5:45 to go. On the left side, Antri takes it in for a touchdown. Touchdown, Genoa.
Here we go.
Here we go. It's not over yet.
Nice job. Nice job getting inside and doing what he does best.
That's what you hope for, and that makes something. Well, are they going to go for two? Or do you kick the field, the point after? It looks like they're going to kick the point after. I thought maybe since they had the other one blocked, they might go for two, but here's the point after attempt. And that one is good, courtesy of the foot of Cam Agler. So we've got 5:41 to go here in the third, and hey, Genoa's right back in it as they trail 21-13.
If you're looking for fantastic Italian food along with old world hospitality and family traditions, D'Estasio's is your place. Located in Elmore, Ohio, Coach Mike D'Estasio and his family have become a fast favorite with pizza, lasagna, and other great old world Italian dishes. Stop out today or call them at 419-862-0404. D'Estasio's, 351 Rice Street in Elmore, Ohio.
Hey, Mick, I just want to say, make sure we get names right and everything. A buddy of mine just texted me here, and it's Case and it's Boose. And I may be saying it wrong. You might be. Some one of us is. So it's Case.
I say Case.
Case, Boose.
Yeah, I know it's Case. I say Case.
So it's me.
I'm not saying it's you. I'm just saying.
Mick, you don't do anything wrong. I know better.
Stop it. Cameron Agler set to kick off here as the Comets, a nice sustained drive. That allows their defense to rest up and see if they can come up with a big stop here in this next series. Ball grabbed at the 25-yard line. Good return.
Uh-oh.
Fighting through.
Nice job.
Out near midfield. That was Hesselbart. That was the guy, the returner. And let's see where they spot. They're going to spot it at about the 49-yard line. So a 24-yard return here for the Eagles, Hesselbart. And great field position to start this next series.
Boy, that second effort right there, man. Really good stuff.
Yep, you can't ask for better.
Hey, Dave Truman keeps texting me here saying that the NBC Championship is going to be on 9:20, and it's got to be for golf. Girls golf, I'm pretty sure it's girls golf. So.
Yep, here we go now. Going over the right side is DeFalco as he gets into Genoa territory on the first carry and drives to about the 46-yard line. So they'll call it a 5-yard pickup, second and five here for the Eagles.
I hate it when I say names wrong like that. You know, it makes me just bummed.
It's all right. No sweat. No harm, no foul.
He's going to keep it.
And now Boose is going to keep it. He's got a room to run, and he is going to go almost untouched to the end zone.
Wow.
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 46 yards, virtually nobody touching him, and Case Boose has lit it up again for the Eagles.
Well, look at this. The one thing that he's been able to do all night is pick on this side of the line, and he's done a really good job with it. And, boy, I mean, he is really, even though we lost our signal there a little bit, boy, incredible stuff for him, though.
Indeed, 46-yard scamper. He has been just the difference here tonight here for Eastwood. And point after is good. So with 4:53 to go here in the third quarter, Eastwood expanding their lead as it's now 28-13.
At Genoa Custom Interiors, we provide quality service at competitive prices. We offer a variety of flooring and interior design options customized to fit your needs. From carpets to hardwood, no matter what type of flooring you desire, we have what you want. Our designers will show you how to set up furniture, flooring, window treatments. Contact us today for a free estimate for any of our interior design, installation, and services. Genoa Custom Interiors.
Set to kick off for the Eagles. Back to the Comets, number 24, Robert Messenger, and number 27, Aiden Antry.
So the Eagles on a 46-yard touchdown run Boos has been the difference here today for Eastwood.
That kid,
he would be the star of the game if it weren't for the fact that we got to pick the unsung hero.
Right, right. So we have to look at people that have done, somebody's doing blocking for him. You know what I mean?
People that are contributing
otherwise. Sure, sure.
That one's going to go. That one's going to go through the end zone for a touchback. So first and 10 from the Genoa 20-yard line. My goodness. I was just wondering what kind of adjustments that were going to be made, but right now.
You got to stop Boose.
Yeah, that's pretty much the number one thing.
Yeah, he's done a really good job at just finding where he needs to find things, and doing a nice job.
Well, first and 10 here for the Comets. They're pretty much going to go aerial most of the rest of the way.
Ooh.
Run course. Flushed out of the pocket, throws it, it goes incomplete.
Front court pass intended for number 27, Aiden
Antry. As Antry was officially the intended target. So it's second and 10, clock stops with 4:48 here in the third.
Don't forget, we'll be out at Heather Downs Country Club tomorrow for our golf show.
Unless you're watching this on television, in which case.
Right, Saturday mornings yesterday. From 8 to 10.
In which case, we were there yesterday. Yep. Here now, Brunkhorst fires it off on the right side to Messenger.
Keep that clock going, too.
Yep.
Third down.
So it's going to
see what.
I don't know if he got anything.
Coverage for the Eagles, number 16, Andrew Bateman.
And it got a yard. So it'll be third and 9.
Next week, we made a change in our schedule. We're going to be doing the Otsego-Rossford game next Friday night.
So we'll be at Jackson Ferguson Stadium.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Now, here's Brunkhorst. Thought about throwing it downfield, but he's forced out of bounds.
He didn't get it either.
Nope. Picked up a little bit of real estate, but not enough for a first down.
Forced out of bounds by number 16, Andrew
Badenhop. So Badenhop forces him out. That stops the clock with 4:03.
From the count at 29.
Well, here we go. This is going to be interesting now. It's obviously a punting situation. But, they're going to go for it. Deep in their own end. Brunkhorst is going to try and draw him off.
Nope.
He's going to keep it. He's going to run forward and gets popped. Now it's going to depend on how far he – I don't think he did.
No, he didn't do it.
That was – nope. They already have a signal first and 10 for Eastwood.
Yeah, watch this.
So let's see on the replay here. Turnover on downs.
I think he waited a little too long when he took that step back.
Yep.
And Eastwood just was everywhere.
Yep. Badenhop and Hesselbart were the two guys that really shut the door.
Eastwood takes over first and 10 from the Comet 29 yard line.
Eastwood already just outside the red zone of Genoa. 3:55 remaining here in third quarter. Eastwood threatening to blow the doors open here. Now Boos. They hand the ball off.
Yeah, now it's just all about controlling the clock. Controlling the clock.
Yep, that's what you want.
You don't want Boos to get hurt.
No, you
know,
don't.
You're at a position here in the game where, we can just run it up the middle. We can get 3-4 yards up the middle. And even where they're positioned right now, they could probably even go for a field goal on fourth down if they got there.
Well, we'll see what happens here. It's second and 6 from the Genoa 25-yard line. Boos hands the ball off as he will dish it to Reynolds, and Isaac Reynolds doesn't get much.
Isaac Reynolds on the carry, first hit by number 3, Braylon Bryant.
So he's brought down by Bryant, and that'll be no gain, they're saying. So clock will continue to run here. So third down and six from the 25-yard line of Genoa. Boos has been, he's been the difference maker here for the Eagles. Throwing for a couple of touchdowns and, or running for a couple of touchdowns and running for, and throwing for one. Here now, Boos rolling out to the left side. He's going to try and turn up field, but he's taken out of bounds. That'll stop the clock. Did not get the first down. So good job there by the Genoa defense. They were able to cover on that play. They're going to say a pickup of a yard, so that'll make it fourth down and five. Clock stops with 2:16 to go.
We have over 400 people listening to this game on our internet feed. We do apologize for last week. We still don't know what happened. I contacted my company in New York, and they're kind of like you, Mick. They never want to be wrong, you know.
Yeah.
And
but still are. And in my case, I still am.
There you go.
So here we go. Fourth down and five. Eastwood going to go for it. They're going to throw it. Flushed out. Now is Boos. Boos.
Not
going to get there.
It could be a flag, though.
Uh-oh.
Is it?
Driven out of bounds. Just got the flag.
There was a flag?
Let's see. They're saying yes. Let's hold the phones here.
Something's going on. Or as my buddy McGruff would say,
a loss of three, and the Eagles will turn the ball over on downs.
Oh, no, there wasn't. Unless it was they were just doing that to Mark where he went out. But it's a turnover on downs here for Genoa.
So almost like a punt, right?
Not really. But the thing is that the point is that clock not being the friend here to Genoa, they need to be able to move the ball.
Yeah, got to do something here.
Wrong course.
And that airs could be it out right deep. There.
Got a receiver in stride. Great pass to Antry. He'll take it down all the way inside the 30-yard line.
I'm telling you, that's a college quarterback throw right there. Beautiful, right up the middle. The route was perfect.
He was, what a
nice job.
I mean, just fantastic.
Mick, you couldn't have done better.
That was a 44-yard pass play.
Beautiful.
And, yeah, you're right, I couldn't, no matter how many times I tried. First and 10 here for the Comets. And that is Antry once again. This time he stopped. As Hasselbart in on the stop. Hasselbart, he's a 6'1", 181-pound senior.
Second and nine.
Mm-hmm. Second and nine here at the 28 of Eastwood. A 1:20 to go in the quarter. So, Brunkhorst under center. He's going to drop back. He's going to pull it down, and he's going to run, and he's going to get out of bounds. Well, they're going to say no. The clock's going to continue to run.
Well, that time Eastwood did what they needed to do and kept that guy back. They didn't let the safety get up, so there was nothing they could do. There was nothing there for him.
So a pickup of a couple, and that's it. All that for 2 yards. And that'll make it third down and seven. The ball at the 26-yard line. So we come up here on a half minute remaining in the third quarter. Excuse me. As Peter Brady would say, is it on to change? Trips out to the right. Brunkhorst looking for somebody. Airs it out. And it's a touchdown pass. Oh, my goodness. 26-yard touchdown pass.
Tony, we've seen it all tonight, Mick.
My goodness. Alex Spencer hauls in the toss from Aiden Brunkhorst, and all of a sudden, it's a 28-19 game with a point after still to come.
Wow.
My goodness. Well, let's get the point after attempt because I want to see that one again.
Well, I didn't get that.
Oh, Agler kicks it through. And with 15 seconds left in the third, all of a sudden things get more interesting here as Genoa closes the gap.
The score, Eastwood 28.
Mike Jamison and Jamison's Mobile Music would like to talk to you about your entertainment needs for your upcoming wedding or special event. For over 25 years, Mike has made wonderful memories one event at a time. Professional sound and lighting and video for your special event. Call us today for an affordable package for your special day. 419-514-1302. Jamison's Mobile Music and Video.
Set to kick for the Comets, number 56, Cameron Agler. Back deep for the Eagles, number 11.
So Agler set to kick off here. That was just a beautiful pass for Hayden Brunkhorst.
He's just got a monster arm on him.
Very talented indeed. This one's going to be bounced, picked up around the 20. And it's going to go out of bounds, or they're going to be forced out of bounds. Oliver, the return man on that play.
Knocked out by number 12.
So it'll be first and 10 here for the Eagles. Mason Drummond defensively able to take him out. It'll be first and 10 for the Eagles at their own 37. 10 seconds left here in the third. So they'll run a play here, and that should do it for the third quarter. Now watch them do something, go out of bounds, and make me look silly.
Not you.
Me? No. Here's DeFalco. He doesn't get out of bounds, thank you, as he will pick up several yards to end quarter number three. So Denver Stewart in on the tackle, but that will make it three quarters done here in Eastwood, as they'll switch sides and start the fourth quarter. It is 28-20. Eastwood leading Genoa. This is the Toledo Sports Network.
Different problems require different solutions. Seagate Roofing and Foundation Services has been solving water problems for over 30 years. We have the expertise to provide you with the best solution. Seagate replaces foundations, straightens walls, lifts sinking foundations, and waterproofs basements. Get your free estimate before you make a decision because you deserve to have all the facts. We are the local experts.
244 LEAK Seagate.
In the fourth quarter, Otsego 15, Elmwood 14.
Oh. Wow.
Hello.
Yeah, that Otsego Elmwood game looks like it's being a monster, too.
Yep, 15-14 currently. Otsego leading Elmwood.
To start the fourth quarter.
So we're starting quarter number four. Things very interesting here as Genoa refuses to mail it in. They trailed 28-20. So we head into the final 12 minutes. Second and four here for Eastwood. And now gutting through DeFalco, fighting his way into Genoa territory, gets all the way down to around the 40-yard line. I think that's where they're going to spot it. So it'll be first and 10 here for Eastwood.
You haven't heard that name. You haven't heard number 24 too much in the third quarter here, Mick. But I'll tell you what, he's a force.
And he's one of the guys I'm considering here for.
I figured.
So for Taylor's unsung heroes, Taylor Key is unsung hero of the game. We're picking one from each side. So here now. One. Boost keeps it. He's off to the races again. This is not a recording. Case Boost, 40 yards, touchdown Eastwood.
Wow, You can't stop him tonight, Mick. You just can't stop him.
My goodness, that line there in the middle opened up like it just opened up and parted there like the Red Sea.
Wow.
And next thing you know, Boose comes to a stop in the end zone. And you see right there,
wow,
the high bump with Daquan Oliver. Of course, Oliver set this whole drive up with the good kick return.
Yes. And as much as Bose has done all of this stuff, it's been his offensive line that has let him get where he needed to get.
That's key. So now, I don't know what's going on here. Are the officials talking with Craig Rutherford and I don't know if they needed to get another player out there. I think that's what it was. So, point after attempt here coming from Eastwood.
Mm.
Waiting for the officials to get into place. And now, finally, looks like we're going to be able to do that. Well, here's the point after attempt. The snap, the kick is, oops. I don't know what that was. That's what we would call a hiccup, as Rothenbuehler sent that one right into the line. So, with 11:24 to go now, it's a two-score ball game. 34-20, Eastwood. It's a 14-point ball game, and we're only 36 seconds into the fourth quarter. Stranger things have happened, so every time you get ready to count Genoa out, you can't because they fight back. And that's a lot of character on this team. And, of course, same can be said about Eastwood. We watched him week one, Mike, against Ottawa Glandorf. And even though they came up short in that game, it was, here's the kick. Grabbed at about the 7-yard line over the 25. Man, oh man. Good return there from Robert Messenger. He's able to fight his way out near the 30-yard line.
Hard fought yards.
So with 11:17 to go here in the ball game, Genoa, I would think that.
Oh, they're going to air it out. They got to air it out.
But you got to run enough so that they don't just play you for the pass.
Well, right now it's been the big pass plays that have helped Genoa out, where the big running plays have helped out Eastwood.
Well, Eastwood Boos has been the difference maker.
Certainly.
And, well, we'll see what Brunkhorst can do here because he's been great with that arm. Brunkhorst is going to keep it. He's going to drive forward. And he'll pick up maybe 3 yards, maybe four.
I'd laugh every time.
Right.
See, you're as bad as me.
No, I just want to sing Hotel California.
Oh, boy,
I
don't.
I get the whole flock of Eagles reference, but like I said, I just think of Eagles and I think automatically Hotel California. Evil album. Mm-hmm. Anyway. Pick up of about 4, it looks like. So second down and 6. Ball at the 34. Here's the handoff to Antry. Antry going forward. And he'll be about 2 yards shy of the first down.
On the carry, brought down by number 57, Julio Rayford.
Rayford in on the stop here for Eastwood. That's going to make it third and short. They're going to spot the ball at the 33-yard line, that looks like. Or, I'm sorry, the 37-yard line. So it's going to be they need three to pick up the first. Under 10 minutes to go in the game. Man in motion. Runcorss hands the ball off. On the left side, we've got a flag called. We'll see what the penalty is. See what they're calling. Holding against Genoa.
That will be declined, my friend.
Well, I think they may back them up, though. Because right now, if you're Eastwood, your line is getting the job done.
Is it third on down or
that
fourth?
That was third, yep.
So it'll be fourth down.
No, it's going to be, if they take the penalty.
Oh, right. But if they don't take the penalty, it'll be fourth and three.
So they are going to decline it. So that makes it fourth down. Karnak,
are you doubting me?
No, not
Nick,
at all,
you
got to
quit that. Just like the thing with the parking today. Don't doubt me. You had the band director ready to fisticuff with you.
And it wouldn't have been pretty. I would have, never mind. Anyway.
It's hilarious.
Nice band director. Here's the blitz.
Oh,
and it's tipped.
Intercepted.
And it's intercepted.
Yep.
How do you like that?
Wow.
As it was snagged by Zach Sheldrick.
Now let's watch that again.
Sheldrick just said, hey, what's
this? Right through the hand. Boom, yep. And hello.
Mr. Sheldrick comes up with it, and a great defensive stand by the Eastwood Eagles.
So at this point, Mick, what do? Do you want to take some time off that clock just in case?
Yes, you do.
Yeah, you just want to take some time off the clock.
But the thing is that if your front line is getting the job done, take advantage of it.
Yes, if Case can get through like he's been able to get through, I mean
they've been parting like the Red Sea there.
Exactly.
For him.
It isn't even holes. I mean, you know, it's just wide open space where he's getting to.
His last two touchdowns, he wasn't even touched. So here we go. On the left side, that is Bryce Hesselbart. As he's able to pick up around, looks like about four. So he's brought down by Drummond, and that'll make it second down and manageable. Looks like about four, so second and six. Coming up here on 9 minutes remaining here in the ball game. Here we go, second and six from the 34. Here's the handoff over on the left side. And I believe it's Andre Lewis, his first carry today. So he's brought down again by Drummond.
Gain of two. We'll bring up third and four from the 32.
So
I'm not a – I won't play Karnak on this one, but I'm betting Boost gets the ball right now.
You think?
I'm just not betting. I'm not betting because betting's not good.
No, and it's also illegal.
Exactly.
So, this is for entertainment purposes only.
Yes. And we love entertainment.
That's what we do. Here's the snap, Boost. This, again, what a surprise. Ball is fumbled, and it looks like Genoa picks it up. So, a recovery here by Genoa. They needed a break if they're going to do it. Now is the time. You see there on the replay.
Yep. Down it went.
Down she went, and it's going to be turned over. And the most important thing for Genoa out of that is they didn't give up that first down, but
right.
They also didn't give up points. And that's what they need right now. If they're going to get back in this, they're down two scores. They need to get back in this, and they need to do it now. They've only got just under 8 minutes to go. Empty backfield. Brunkhorst fires a dart. Right side, that is complete over there to Mason Drummond.
They're leaving that wide open. And that little cut right there, they're getting that 10 yards, 10, 15 yards, 12 yards, and it works out real well for them.
And the pickup was for 11 and a first down. So they're going to no huddle. Trips out to the left, Twins to the right. Brunkhorst looks downfield, over the middle again.
Wow.
It's complete. And all the way inside of Eastwood territory, they'll bring them down at about the, oh boy, we got a flag, so.
Yeah, let's look at it.
This might be a late hit. It's where the quarterback is. It's going to depend on, it could either be a hold on the line,
yeah,
or it's a late hit. We'll see. See what the referee says. It is a personal foul.
Face mask
against Eastwood. So they're going to tack that on. That's a 15-yarder, buddy. So that's instant red zone. That should be instant red zone here for the Genoa Commons. Yeah, he's taking it all the way down. So it will be, he was brought down at the 30. And they marked him down at the 30, and then with the 15-yard penalty on top of it, means first and 10 from the 15. 7.5 minutes to go. And here we go. Here's Brunkhorst. He's going to fire it over the left side to Austin Teat.
You get that?
Incomplete.
Intended for number 14, Austin Teat.
That'll stop the clock. My goodness.
Ah, just dropped it.
Yep. So, second and 10 here for the Comets. 7:16 left to go here in this football game. Again, empty backfield here for Aiden Brunkhorst. Rolling out now to the right, being flushed out. Gets the pass away, throws it right into the hands. Oh, my goodness. What a tough break as he threw it right into the hands of Bryce Hasselbart.
Check it out again.
Christmas gift right there.
No one there.
No one even close. And that was because he was getting tackled as he threw the football. Yep, it hit his arm as he threw the football. And it shortened the toss, and it went right into the hands of Hasselbart. So, first and 10 here for Eastwood. 7:05 on the clock. Now, you talk about clock management, just running the clock out.
Certainly.
That's what they want to do right here. They're now going through there is DeFalco.
DeFalco on the carry. First hit by number 9, Denver Stewart.
Brought down by Denver Stewart.
You got to say, though, Mick, in this game, it's been a pretty damn clean game. Haven't had a lot of penalties. You haven't had any penalties, I think, what do we have, two, maybe three the whole game?
Yeah, just a few.
Which is very good for both teams.
Yeah.
There's a lot of discipline there. I apologize to people that I said the word damn.
That's all right.
Twice.
Yeah, I know. Let's see. Here we go. Second and 10. Tossed over here on the left side. Pass is almost caught by DeFalco, but couldn't haul it in, so it falls incomplete. That'll make it third and 10. Also stops the clock, which helps Genoa.
Yeah, that's exactly why you don't want to do anything like that, where you would think that you would just keep running it up the middle, and because it stops your clock.
If you're down 14 right now, if you're Genoa, if you can come up with a stop and not give up a first down, I think you call a timeout here.
Sure.
Well, we'll see what happens here. This young man, Mr. Boos, is just dynamite here tonight. And ball handed up and. Oh, my goodness. All the way out over the 40-yard line. Hasselbart, I think everyone was keying in on Boos.
I think you're right.
And Hasselbart just darted right there, followed his blocks, was able to fight his way through, and a big, big first down here, which I think is going to take the final wins out of the sails here for Genoa.
Yeah, nobody saw that coming, Mick.
Nope.
Nice job.
Great job by that Eastwood offense, that offensive line. They did a great – well, they've been doing a great job all night, but on that play specifically to put – try and drive a final nail in the coffin here on this series. Clock not the friend of Genoa right now.
We thank all you people that have been online and watching our game. We really appreciate you a lot. And
those of you on TV, we appreciate you equally.
Yes, yes, yes.
Here's the handoff to DeFalco.
DeFalco on the carry. First hit by number 24, Robert Messenger. Finished off by number 34, Don Lindenberger.
So, we're getting into Genoa's going to have to start using timeout territory.
Second and six from the Eagle.
Second and six. That ball at the... looks like they spotted at the 46. Like one more, one to two more first downs will do it here for Eastwood. Here's Boos. He hands it off to DeFalco. So, have you thought of your unsung heroes yet?
You know, I'm going to have to...
brought to you, by the way, by Taylor Kia and the Taylor Automotive family. Big thank you to Mr. Steve Taylor. Also, of course, Tom Cole and Terry Crosby, our friends over, all of them over there at Taylor Kia.
Not Taylor Automotive Group.
Or Taylor Automotive. I say them both because I say Taylor Hyundai. And
it's, you know, different, though.
Yeah,
that's,
I know. The, but they're, it's their...
That's why I don't like you doing sponsor mentions.
But that's okay. I still love the whole bunch. As timeout's going to be taken by Eastwood here with 4:14. But let's keep it here.
No, we're going to go.
Okay,
we're
going to go that way. Back after this, it's 34-20 Eastwood.
Hey, everybody, it's Steve Taylor from the Taylor Automotive family. It is September, and that means it is Free Car Friday. All month long, we're giving away another vehicle at the end of this month, and you could be the lucky winner this month. You know, we've already given away six fantastic vehicles this year. This month, we're going to change things up a little bit. We're having a scavenger hunt. You can get a golden ticket anywhere in Northwest Ohio. We'll be out and about in the communities, Toledo, Perrysburg, Findlay, Lima. We will have some of our people out in the communities. We'll let you know on Facebook where we'll be. We'll give you clues, and all you have to do is come up and get one of those golden tickets, and that means you got a chance to win this fantastic vehicle in September. It is simple, but don't forget, you got to go to our Facebook page. You got to like, comment, and share on that pinned post. It is that easy. Have some fun in September. Be on the lookout for the golden ticket, and maybe you can win that new car. We'll see you. Have a good one.
Great shot there of the alumni band. As we welcome you back here to Freedom Field here at Jerry Rutherford Stadium.
Out of the timeout.
And, of course, now I see why you wanted to go to break there.
Yeah, I had it all cued. I figured we were going to do it. Everything would have been perfect.
And it was. Mm-hmm. So, here we go. Third and two. Ball, they're spotting it now at midfield. Here's Boos. Oh.
Flags everywhere.
False start here on Eastwood. So that'll knock him back 5 yards. And most importantly for Genoa, no time off the clock. So that'll make it third and seven at the Eastwood 45-yard line. They need to get it to the 48 of Genoa to move the chains. So
what's it going to be again now, Mick?
It is third and seven. Ball is at the 45 of Eastwood. Well, here we go. Boos looking to throw it, flushed out of the pocket. He's going to run with it, and he's going to be brought down.
And stayed inbounds.
Yep. See, right there, if I was Genoa, I'd be taking a timeout. You don't let the clock run like this when you're down two scores. That's interesting. I'll just say that. So, we'll see what happens here on this fourth down kick. Maybe they're hoping for a TD run. A kick return or something. I don't know, but if I'm Eastwood, I'm taking all the time I can off this clock.
Ooh,
high snap, but it's handled easily. Beautiful kick. And a fair catch called at about the 18-yard line, maybe 17. We'll see where they spot 17. So it's essentially it is first and
16-yard line.
It's first and 83. So
basically.
Yeah, it's first and 83. So
you and your geometry.
Hey, you know, we learn fingers and toes over there at
Central.
Yes, yeah, that school.
Yeah, I got you.
We tried.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, speaking of which of that school, a big shout out to Scott Winkowski, attorney at law.
He's a great golfer. Did you know that?
I've heard.
He could even teach you how to golf, Mick.
No, that you can heal the sick, but you can't raise the dead. As that one, talking about golf games here,
okay.
As that one goes incomplete, so that'll make it second and 10. Clock stops, 3:16 to go, and.
All right, let's do our Unsung Hero Awards. You want mine?
Yes, go. You go.
All right, for Eastwood, you ready for Eastwood?
Yeah, go for it.
The offensive line. Thank you, Dave Truman. Period.
Yep, I have to agree.
I mean.
This one's tossed on the left side or right side. Is that caught? That's the question. And
I don't think it.
Nope, it's not caught. But now over on the Genoa side.
You know, I'm going to have to go with a quarterback only for the main reason of he's been able to show something that Genoa has not been able to show over the years. That passing game, he's just played real well. You know, when Sutter was in there, Sutter was a heck of a quarterback and was able to do a lot of things and move around and throw the ball big. And there he goes right there again.
Yep, and fires a dart to Messenger, who picks up the first down. Ooh. I was going to say, I think Eastwood got away with a face mask there.
Yep. So those are my two right there.
All right, that's fair enough, and I'll agree with you on both.
Well, there we go. We never agree, Mac. Come on. Are you kidding me?
No, I agree completely.
Wow.
It's common sense.
Look at this.
Now here. Oh. Double coverage there is. Run course. Tried to throw out to find Alex Spencer, but that was scary there for a minute because both Boos and Caleb Souter were right there in his grill.
I cannot believe I agreed with Dave Truman on something.
Hey, will wonders never cease?
Uh-huh.
Play the lottery. Here's their rush in the quarterback. Pass is complete.
First down, buddy.
That's what you want.
Well, like you said, it's got to stop the clock. It's got to make things happen like that. You're two scores down. You got to make, you know, they'll move the chains and it'll fire the clock up again. But
if these guys score and they don't win, the big scuttlebutt's going to be, why didn't you call a timeout on fourth down?
I'll give you that.
Here we go. Oh, another dart over to the Messenger.
Oh. He annihilated him.
Yeah, I'd say so. Messenger's a tough cookie. So let's see what, I mean.
About second and one, second and two.
Eight, they're saying. So second and two. 2.5 to go here in the ball game.
Yeah, but it is two.
Ball will be spotted at the Eastwood 42-yard line.
Both games that we've done from Eastwood so far this year, Otto Glandorf and this one. Just
entertaining
really,
ball games.
Yeah, definitely. And it's not over yet.
Here we go. Brunkhorst is going to take a shot deep. And that one was overthrown. At least everyone got to see how strong of an arm.
Kid's got a freaking arm, man.
Yeah. So that stops the clock with 2:24. And Genoa right now. They've got work to do. Here's the snap. Brunkhorst going to keep it, drive forward. He wants to get outside so he can move the sticks and stop the clock.
Nice job.
Which he does. So, 2:17 remaining. They'll move the chains. Looks like they're going to spot it at around the 32. So first and 10 here from the Eagle 32, 2:17 to go. Runcorse going to look deep. He's going to take another shot.
Oh!
And a big collision.
Wow.
Pro Golf Fairways at Cameo Pizza and Resets in Rossford and Monroe Street right next to Nick and Jimmy, with top-of-the-line golf simulators, duckpin bowling, and the best food for your night out. We've got you covered. It's Pro Golf Fairways with all the greatest golf courses in the area. Why not come out and hit a few with us at Pro Golf Fairways at Cameo Pizza and Resets in Rossford and Monroe Street next to Nick and Jimmy.
Well, personal foul call on the Eagles. So that'll make it first and 10 from the Eastwood 15. Where have I heard that before?
Huh.
So.
Well, it's been a clean game. It really has been a clean game. But
just a lot of.
When you get into this predicament here.
High impact
Genoa,
plays, yeah.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
First and 10 here for the Comets. Brunkhorst rolling out to his left. Fires it out a little too far, and that goes incomplete.
Gets Rick on camera.
Well, I wish we had a replay of that from his point of view.
I hope he paid those parking tickets.
Just saying. Well, that stops the clock, 2:06 to go.
Once again, tomorrow, if you're listening right now and not on TV, we'll be live on ESPN 100.7.
Well, here we go, second and 10. Brunkhorst fires over the middle, complete, touchdown. And in for the touchdown is Mason Drummond. Or I'm sorry, Drummond, let's try that.
Yeah.
I was trying to say Drama and Drummond at the same time. But Mason Drummond hauls it in.
Oh, nice job, too.
From 15 yards for the touchdown here for Genoa. And again, they refuse to give up.
Yep.
High snap, ball is down, kick is up, and the kick is missed.
Yep.
Oh, my goodness. So with 2:01 to go here in, that hurts.
Oh, yeah.
But they still have a shot at it. They still have a shot at it, so they can score a touchdown in a two-point conversion. And they fall on it.
Coming in and helping us out a little bit.
If you're watching this on Sunday morning, thank you for listening in yesterday. And we thank them for.
And you're on the air Sunday from 9 to 10 on 100.7.
Yeah.
The cheap seats.
Issues. Here we go, second and 10.
He's got it one.
And, well, Boost diving forward.
Hell no.
Minute 43, here we go. As Boost hands it off. And they're not going to get the first down. So a timeout going to be taken here. Fourth down here is Eastwood will punt. And a beautiful kick. And it's going to go into the end zone barely.
Unsung hero award.
Yes, the Taylor Automotive Unsung Heroes. The offensive line for the Eastwood Eagles and Aaron Brunkhorst for Genoa. And Brunkhorst now trying to lose his.
No, he
yeah, but
he
that
tried
should be grounding
it.
He
no
tried
flag,
to get rid
though.
Of
it. I think he got outside the.
He was outside the box and he threw it past the line of scrimmage. So that it kind of reminded me of the old. If you're a person of a certain age, you might remember the old Kenny Stabler fumbled forward.
Sure.
The forward fumble.
It started it all, didn't it?
Yep, sure did. Buck 24 to go. Empty backfield again here for Brunkhorst. He'll take the snap. Dropping back, facing the heat, lets it go. It goes out of bounds. Clock stops, but, well, they need to get a first down. And right now, they're only rushing like three, and they're getting through. the Eagles are. So
I think there's one more guy that's going out for the pass too, Mick.
Yeah, I mean, it's an empty backfield. For Genoa, they've got to come up with a first down here. They got two shots at it. Trips out to the right. Ball near the left hash. Brunkhorst fires it. And his receiver hadn't run his route, Austin Teat. His back was still to the ball when that ball was thrown, but Brunkhorst had to let it go because he was going to get hit. And that front line of Genoa is gassed because they're letting these guys get through. I mean, the last several plays, it's like they've almost been untouched. They've just been able to sail right through. But this is the ball game here. Minute 14, 4th and 10.
Brunkhorst is shaking.
Yep, Brunkhorst takes the snap. He's going to look downfield. Got a pass. It goes incomplete. And, well, that's going to do it. As Eastwood will take the turnover on downs and enjoy a victory, but it wasn't easy.
Wrap it up quick, too, Mick.
Well, should be the two most favorite words of any coach to a quarterback in terms of play calling. All together, kids. 1, 2, 3.
Victory
formation.
Yes.
So, Boos will take the snap. And he'll take the knee. So, they'll have to take one more snap. They'll take one more snap here to officially end the game. As the clock winds down, big thank you again to all of our sponsors. Again, our Taylor Automotive Group, unsung heroes of the game, the front line for Eastwood, quarterback Aiden Brunkhorst for Genoa, as they will take a knee once again here as the star of the game today obviously has to be Mr. Case Boos, as he will take the knee, and that will do it. As Eastwood with just an impressive victory here over the Genoa Comets, as they defeat the Comets by a score of 34-26. Big thank you again to all of our sponsors. We can't thank you enough. Thank you, folks, for tuning in wherever you're tuning in from. We appreciate it greatly. For our camera crew, for Rick and Kurt, for Mike Jamison down in the production truck, I am Mick Gonzalez saying so long, everybody, here from Freedom Field inside of Jerry Rutherford Stadium. As your final, once again, the Eastwood Eagles defeat the Genoa Comets by a score of 34-26. As you've been watching high school football here on the Toledo Sports Network.